Hi, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how you can make these notebook cards in Word, but also how to create these cutting lines. So I'm going to open a new project. So as you can see, I've got my default document here, it's just A4, and I'm going to go up to Layout and across to Orientation, click on the drop down and select Landscape. So we've now got a landscape project. And I'm going to insert the guidelines. Now, I'm not going to put those into the main document. I'm actually going to put them in the headers and the footers. This way, I don't disturb them while I'm trying to create my other design just in the page, but it's kind of there in the background. So I'm going to double click at the top of my page. Another way to get into the headers and footers is to go up to Insert, Headers and Footers, click on the drop down and go down to Edit Header. And there you are in your headers and your footers. So I'm going to go up to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and insert a line. Now I'm just going to click, hold down my Shift key because that will mean I have a perfectly vertical line. And I'm just going to go from the top to the bottom of my page. Once I've got that line there, I'm just going to edit that line just so I can see it a little bit better and to just ensure I know it's the cutting line. So select it, go to Shape Format, go all the way over to Format Pane. Go to Dash Type, click on the drop down and select the dash that you want. Go to Width, this is the width of your line. I'm going to just click on the up arrow until the line is the thickness I want. Then go to Color and I'm just going to click on a dark gray. Okay, once that's inserted, make sure it's selected. You can tell it's selected, it's got these little green balls either end. Then go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and click Align to Center. And that will mean that that line is now perfectly in the center. Then I'm going to do exactly the same, click Insert, Shape and click on the line. Now the reason I'm doing this all over again rather than copy and pasting it is because when you copy and paste it, you can't use the Shift key to get that perfect line. Let's just go back, draw out that line, there we go. Then back over to here, dash type, I'm going to select that dotted one there. Width, I'm just going to click until I'm happy, change that color again to dark gray, and then back up to align, but this time select align to middle. Perfect. Now, if we double click back into the center of our page, you can see now we've come out of the headers and footers, and these lines remain, they're slightly grayed out, but I can't actually move them and I can't touch them, which is great. So now we've got our four equal quarters of our page. I'm now going to go in and put the detail. So I'm going to put some text in. So I'm going to insert, text box, click on the drop down, draw text box, click and drag out a text box. Just going to type in notes. And then if you deselect it, you can see that this comes with a black border and a white background. You can see that white background there. So I'm going to get rid of those both, select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline, go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down, No Fill. Now you can see it's completely transparent, and when I deselect it, there's no outline. I'm going to change this text, select it, go to Home, click on my fonts, and I'm going to select this Balania font here, and then this increase font size tool here. I'm just going to increase that until I'm happy. Let's just move that up like that. And now I'm going to copy and paste it. Now you can use the normal copy up here and paste, or you can use Command or Control C followed by Command or Control V. But the quickest way is to select it, hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag. They're both selected now, so again click and drag, and then you can place them where you want. Once you've done that, you can go back up to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down, select Draw Text Box, and click and drag out a text box. Now the reason I'm doing this is because I'm going to insert a table. I'm not going to use lines because unfortunately using lines in Word is really tricky. They don't always select very well, they're very tricky to click on, and they move. So the best way to do this is to insert a table. But in order to move that table, the best thing to do is to put it inside a text box. So before we insert the table, select the text box, and we're going to do exactly the same. Go to Shape Format, get rid of that outline, no outline, get rid of the shape fill and select no fill. Then go to insert, go to table, click on the drop down, and then I'm just going to select 8 rows. So I've got my 8 rows here, but I want them a bit wider. So I'm going to select the table by clicking on this cross or the square at the top. Then I'm going to go to layout, and then where it says height, I'm going to increase that height to 1 centimeter and press enter. Now, if you can see, your table disappears because you've put too many in, which I have, but deliberately, so I can show you how to delete them. Just select the bottom one and then drag up to the next one up. So I'm going to take the bottom two out. So I go to layout and click delete, delete cells, and then just click OK. Those cells will be deleted and you have a nice neat table. But now you can move this anywhere in your document. So let's just place it there. If we deselect it, you can keep it like that if you want to, but I'm going to turn these lines grey and I'm going to get rid of the sidelines as well. So again, select this table. Sometimes it won't select. If it doesn't, just keep clicking, double clicking, and eventually it will. Click on the top left square again, go to table design, and go along to this section here that deals with all of your borders or your outlines. So I'm going to change the color of my borders to this dark gray, and that's your pen color there. Then go to borders and select all borders. And now all my borders have changed to that dark grey. And then just to select it again, table design, click on borders. I'm just going to deselect the right border. And then I'm going to deselect the left border. And then what we're left with are just those perfect lines. Once we've done that, we can simply copy and paste in the same way we did before, holding down that Alt or Option key, click and drag. Once they're both selected, again, click and drag. You can make sure they're perfectly lined up if you select one and then hold down the Command or Control key and you can select two at the same time, or you can select multiples. It doesn't matter, it doesn't have to be two. Go to Shape Format, go to Align and select Align to Top and they will be perfectly lined up together. Again, you can do that with the bottom ones, Align, Align to Top. And again, they will be perfectly lined up. In the same way, if you want them lined up to the left, you can select these two, align, align to left, and we can align these up to the right, align, align to right. So it's all lined up left and right and at the top. If you want to keep it like that, great, you can print it out like that or you can save it as a PDF. But if you want a little bit of added extra interest, we can go to Insert, Icons, and over here you can search for anything you like. I normally use flowers, and then I'm going to select this one here and click insert. Once that's inserted, you'll find you can't move it. If that happens, just press Command or Control Z and go back, select the flowers, go to graphics format, go to wrap text and select in front of text. Now you can move them anywhere, and you can also rotate them using the circle. I pop mine here. Not going to be too accurate at the moment because I'm going to copy and paste this again, Alt key, Alt or Option key, and then I'm going to select one more because I'm going to do 3. I've double selected that one, so let's get rid of one. For this one, I'm going to flip it. So select it, go to graphics format, go to rotate, flip vertically, and then we can just rotate that one, move that one up. I think I put this one about here. Now, once you've made a collection, you can actually group them together. So holding down that Command or Control key, click on all three of those flowers, go to Graphics Format, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And now it's one complete item. So again, you can put that wherever you want to. I'm going to put it on the cutting line here. I'm going to use my arrow keys just to nudge that over so that when you cut that line, it cuts perfectly to the edge. Copy and paste the whole thing, again, holding down that Alt or Option key. And then do exactly the same here. Round about there, just pop it down a bit. Perfect. All done. So if you're happy with that, you can go ahead and you can save it, you can print it, you can save it as a PDF and send it to somebody, completely up to you. If at any point you do want to get rid of the cutting lines, then just simply double click at the top of your page, just select one of the lines and then just hit delete. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.